Chrome is the most popular web browser in the world, and one of the ways it's been able to achieve this is by being pre-installed on over 3 billion smartphones. But I know that not everyone is a fan of the Chrome web browser. So in today's video, I'll be showing you how to uninstall the Chrome application from any Android device without the help of root access. That's right. We do not need root in order to install Chrome from the default user account on an Android smartphone or tablet. But before we can get into that process, I want to show people how to disable the application. Disabling an application can be much quicker than executing the ADB command to uninstall it. So if you do not want Chrome on your phone or tablet, the first thing that I recommend you do is find the application icon and long press it so that you can tap on the app info or the I icon in that pop-up. This will bring you to the app info page for Chrome, which we can also get to by opening up the settings app, finding the apps menu, and then selecting the Chrome application from that list. So either way, you'll be brought to a page that looks similar to this, and just note that this page may look slightly different depending on which OEM firmware you're currently using. So instead of going through the process of executing that ADB command that I mentioned earlier, you may be just as happy with disabling the Chrome application from here. We have this disable button that we just want to tap, and then tap disable app. When disabled correctly, you'll either see that button change to disabled, or it will switch over to an enable button. Now, some phones will have this disable button grayed out or removed entirely. However, if you have that option here, then go ahead and disable Chrome from here, and that will prevent it from running on your device. It will not be able to run in the background when it's disabled, nor will it use up any of your battery. However, if you are unable to disable the Chrome application from this page, or if you are dedicated and want it uninstalled completely from your device, then you will need to have some things set up ahead of time. For example, you will need to have ADB and Fastboot tools installed on your PC unless you go with an on-device ADB option like LADB. You will also need to have developer mode enabled on the smartphone or tablet that you want to uninstall Chrome from. And developer mode is required to be enabled so that you can toggle the USB debugging mode feature on. All of this is required since we are not rooting the phone, but if you are not familiar with how to install ADB and Fastboot tools, or if you are not familiar with developer mode or USB debugging mode, then be sure to check the video description below, as I'll have links to dedicated videos that I have done in the past, which will walk you through everything that is involved. Once you have USB debugging mode enabled, and you have ADB and Fastboot tools installed on your PC, then we are ready to begin the uninstall process for removing Chrome on this device. So let's go ahead and connect our phone or tablet to the PC with that USB cable. Now that our phone is connected to the PC with a USB cable, we have opened up a Windows PowerShell from within the same folder as our ADB and Fastboot tools. But you could also choose to open up a command prompt or a terminal window. But again, it must be launched in the same folder as our ADB and Fastboot tools. And the first thing that I do is execute the command ADB space devices. So we're going to press enter. Now we're doing this just to make sure that I have successfully connected the smartphone to the PC and I have USB debugging mode enabled. If you do not see the serial numbers of your phone in response here, if this is blank, then you either haven't enabled USB debugging mode or you haven't granted USB debugging mode access. After you get the proper response from this command, then we can dive into the shell prompt. And we do that by typing out the command ADB space shell and then pressing enter. And this should change the prompt from something that is being executed directly on the PC to a prompt that is executed directly on the device itself. This is why the prompt we have here has the code name of our phone that's connected via the USB cable. And then from here, we're either going to type out the command or we're going to paste the command PM space uninstall space dash K space dash dash user space 0 space com dot Android dot Chrome. And this tells the Android package manager to uninstall the application with the package name com dot Android dot Chrome. The package name will remove it from user account 0, which is our default account. And here we're using the dash K parameter, which will tell that package manager to keep all of the user data intact. And that's just in case you ever decide to reinstall it. There won't be any user data lost during that process. So we're going to press enter on the keyboard. And we're going to look for a success message right here. And that will tell us that everything went smoothly. And we will also know that it worked successfully as the Chrome application and its icon will be nowhere to be found on our smartphone or tablet anymore. You can't find it on the home screen, and you won't be able to find it in the application drawer either because it has been uninstalled from our user account. With that done, the Chrome application will not be able to run in the background on your device. It will not be able to eat up any of your CPU processing power, which could actually make the device feel faster than before. It will also no longer be able to collect all of your private user data that the application is notorious for doing. So, if you ran across any issues during this process, or maybe you just have a question about it before you try it for yourself, then please do not hesitate to leave a comment down below.